talk about the topic cell unit of life and cell division, cell cycle and its division. So in this DPP, that is daily practice problems, we are going to discuss about these two topics for this particular day. I hope you are going on well with your preparation for the NEET or CET, and you will be seeing this topic. So coming on to the first question, the cell organelle involved in glycolysis of protein is A. ribosome, B. peroxisome, endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria. The cell organelle, organelle means ribosome is a cell organelle, and peroxisomes are also organelles, mitochondria. Mitochondria, you know, that powerhouse of the cell. Ribosome is the protein factory. Peroxisome, so here glycolysis means addition of saccharides to proteins and lipids. So glucose bond is attached to the proteins. Here that glycolysis or protein manufacturing is done, ribosome itself is converted into the proteasome. So that conversion is done in the case of the organelle responsible for that is endoplasmic reticulum, C option. So it is responsible for the glycosylation. As a result of glycosylation, you can see that polysaccharides are added to the proteins, and this takes place in the endoplasmic reticulum. Next, the outer layer of vacuole is called, already you know that the layer surrounding the vacuole is named with a specific name called as tonoplast. So your cell wall means it is in the plant, wherever the outer covering is called cell wall. Plasma layer means plasma membrane also. This is present in the animal and plant, that not but vacuole. Leucoplast means white color, chloroplast is called as leucoplast. So from these four options, you can go with the option tonoplast is the answer, which is covering the vacuole. Which of the following cell organelles remains enveloped by a single unit membrane? Mitochondria, two membranes. Nucleus, two membrane. Chloroplast, two to three membranes. Here only the cell organelle which is covered by a single membrane is lysosome. Without membrane is centriole and ribosome. So with single membrane, from the given options is lysosome, that is also called as the suicidal bags of the cell. Next, coming on to the next question, choose the correct option. Lysosomes are double membranous vesicles budded off from Golgi apparatus and contain digestive enzymes. Endoplasmic reticulum consists of a network of membranous tubules, helps in the transportation, synthesis and secretion. Leucoplasts are bound by two membranes, lack pigment but contain their own DNA and protein synthesizing machinery. Spherozomes are single membrane bound organelles which are associated with synthesis and storage of lipids. So from these, if you see, second, third and fourth options are looking to be most appropriate options. Why the first option is wrong means lysosomes are single membranous vesicles. So that is the reason first one is wrong. So we can go with the 2, 3, 3, that is C option is the right option. Coming on to the next question, the nucleolus is the site of formation of. When you look into the textbook, the nucleolus is responsible for the controlling of reproduction function, that is split division function, including the formation of proteins. So it is also called as protein synthetic factory. Here from the given options, the ribosomes can form the proteins. So spindle fibers are present in the centrioles, formed from the centrioles during division only. Chromosomes are also present, which is called as nucleolus. It consists of nucleolus. It undergoes the division. And peroxisomes are a type of oxidative forms which are present, just like the other single unit cells. So here the nucleolus is the site for the formation of ribosomes, where ribosomes are matured in the later stages into the proteins. So here nucleolus is the site for formation of ribosomes. Next, which one of the following combination is mismatched? Glycocalyx, maybe capsule or slime layer, pili reproduction, cell wall, protective, determines shape, prevents from bursting, flagella, pili and fimbriae, surface structures of bacterial. In certain bacterium, pili may act as sex pili, but they are not meant for transfer of material, but not meant for reproduction. So for the other options, if you look, all looks to be almost best, almost correct. So your pili is the only option which is mismatched. We can go with the B. So option B is the right option. The fluidity of membranes in a plant in cold weather may be maintained by increasing the number of phospholipids with the unsaturated hydrocarbon tails, increasing the proportion of integral proteins, increasing concentration of cholesterol in membrane, increasing the number of phospholipids with the saturated hydrocarbon tail. Here from the fluidity of membranes in a plant cell in cold weather may be maintained by increasing the number of phospholipids with unsaturated hydrocarbon tails. This increases the, according to the fluid mosaic model, the hydrophobic and hydrophilic bonds are maintained. They are meant for making the cell structure stable. So here the possibility is from the four options, first option can be the appropriate answer, because you can see that the increasing the number of phospholipids with the unsaturated hydrocarbon tails will increase the fluidity or maintain the fluidity in the plant in cold weather. Now, coming on to the next one, the cell as a basic unit of structure of living things was discovered by Aristotle, father of biology, father of zoology. Robert Hooke, concerned to the cell, and written the book Micrographia, which is concerned with the cell. Schleiden and Schwann put forward the cell theory. Gregor John Mendel, father of genetics. So here cell was put, this was put forward by Robert Hooke only. He is considered to be the father of cell biology. Next, which pair of structures are usually found in both plant and animal cells? Cell membrane and nucleolus, cell membrane and cell wall, nucleolus and chloroplast, nucleus and cell wall. Generally found in both plant cell and animal cell. Cell membrane is found in plant cell, animal cell. Nucleolus is present in the both animal cell and plant cell. Cell membrane is present in the both, but cell wall is only present in plant cell. So second option, wrong option. Nucleolus and chloroplast. Chloroplast is only restricted to green photosynthetic plants. So third option is also wrong. Nucleus and cell wall. Nucleus is present in everyone, but cell wall is only specific to plant cell and certain bacteria. So A option is the right appropriate option, that is cell membrane, also called as plasma membrane in the animals and cell membrane in the plants. So A option is the right option. Most abundant lipid in the cell membrane is cholesterol, phospholipids, glycolipids and serbocytes. Abundant lipid. Lipid means fat containing component. Generally, cell consists of phospholipids. Already we have discussed. So here the answer is phospholipids. Phospholipids are the abundant lipids present in the cell membrane. If you remove the fimbriae from the bacterial cell, which of the following would you expect to happen? So the bacteria could no longer swim, the bacteria could not adhere to the host tissue, transportation of molecules across the membrane would stop, the shape of the bacteria would change. So here when you see onto this, here bacterial cell fimbriae. Fimbriae are meant for attachment, which are also generally called as fimbriae. Pili consists of fimbriae. So here palpably first option, they can swim because they have the trichomes. If they are sedentary, they cannot, the bacteria could not adhere to the host tissue. Transportation of molecules across the membrane would stop. Third one will not happen. The shape of the bacteria will not change. So D also will not happen. Only B can happen in this particular case. So answer for this is the bacteria could not adhere to the host tissue. Cell recognition are facilitated by components of plasma membrane. These components are generally cell recognition and transition and adhesion are facilitated by components of plasma membrane. These components are generally, they are generally protein molecules alone, both lipids alone, both lipids and proteins, glycolipids and glycoproteins. So generally cell recognition components will be acted by the glycolipids and glycoproteins, glycolipids and glycoproteins. Recognition and adhesion are facilitated by components of plasma membrane. These components are generally protein molecules alone, lipid molecules alone, both lipids and proteins, glycolipids and glycoproteins. So these are generally cell recognition and adhesion facilitated by plasma membrane components, which are present as a part of a membrane are called as lipids, and these will be glycolipids and glycoproteins, that is integral proteins, peripheral proteins and other bonds related to that. So it is glycolipids and glycoproteins. Now coming on to the next one, smooth endoplasmic reticulum is well developed in the cells which synthesize A. steroids, B. proteins, C. carbohydrates, D. all of these. Select the option with correct labeling of the given structure of Golgi apparatus. smooth endoplasmic reticulum is well developed in the cells which is synthesized. Already you know that smooth endoplasmic reticulum is responsible for production of certain hormones called as steroidal hormones, which are the protein molecules, but which are the steroidal proteins, so which are modified steroids. So here when you talk about the question, so we know that the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is responsible for protein toxin degradation, as well as they also produces the steroids. So we can go with the answer, steroids. A option. Select the option with the correct labeling of a given structure of Golgi apparatus. So you need to label them cis phase, trans phase when you try to identify. When you try to check the answer, which one from these A is cisternae, B is vesicles form, C is trans phase will be concave phase, convex phase, so it is trans phase, and D is, that is inside will be towards the nucleus will be cis phase. From the given options, when you try to see cisternae, first one A will be cisternae, B will be vesicle, C will be trans phase, and D will be cis phase. So from the given following options, A option is the appropriate option. Next, the molecules in the membrane that limits its permeability are the molecules in the membrane that limit its permeability. Permeability means allowing, or the dash. A. Phospholipid carbohydrates. B. Phospholipids. C. Proteins. D. Water. So here phospholipids are the hydrophobic and hydrophilic, and the movement is generally done by this. So here the permeability is because of the molecules phospholipids only, that is phosphate containing fat molecules. Next, pH of vascular cell sap is pH, generally they consist of digestive enzymes, and their digestive enzymes generally are isotonic, hypotonic, as well as they are also acidic in nature. So generally from this vascular cell sap is acidic and also hypertonic, high concentrations. So from that neutral and isotonic, alkaline and isotonic, acidic and hypertonic, acidic and hypertonic equal to cytoplasm and isotonic. So generally acidic and as well as it is highly concentrated, so hypertonic, obviously C option. Acidic and hypertonic. Next, all plastids have essentially the same structure because they have to perform the same function. They are localized in the aerial parts of a plant. One type of plastids can differentiate into another type of plastids. depending upon the cell requirement, all plastids have to store starch, lipids and proteins. So from the given question, all plastids have essentially the same structure because first one, they have to perform the same function. They can perform the same function or different function. So not first option. They are localized in the aerial parts of the plant. They are present only in the tissues. So it is generally outside only, but essentially the same structure, because when you see the third option, one type of plastids can differentiate into another type of plastids depending upon the cell requirement. Like when you take the chloroplast, okay, in the case of certain plants, it performs photosynthesis. But in the case of stem, like Opuntia, you can see that the stem itself consists of these. So here the presence of cell is the main characteristic feature, and it is also depending on the cell requirements. So we can see the fourth option, all plastids have to store starch, lipids and proteins. That is not essentially done. So here we can only go with the C option. Next, see autonomous organisms. Generally we see that whichever can perform their own functions under the control of nucleus are called as semi-autonomous organelles. And as per the knowledge we have, we know that the organs which carry out their functions by themselves, and which is generally consisting of, which perform their own functions under the control because of having its own DNA. So from the given options, have linear DNA as well as RNA, carry out ATP synthesis, have quantosomes embedded in the thylakoid membrane, occurs in photosynthetic organisms. Find out the correct number of statements with respect to plastids. So here, what are the functions of the plasmids? Plastid is a semi-autonomous organelle. So first option is right. Next, carry out ATP synthesis. ATP synthesis may not take place. Have quantosomes embedded in the thylakoid membrane. Two right. And occurs in all photosynthetic organisms. So here, semi-autonomous organelles have quantosomes embedded in the thylakoid membrane, occurs in the photosynthetic organisms. So three options are given options are the right options from the given one. Select the incorrect matching elaioplast, oil plast, chromoplast, colored plastids, mitochondria, fission in G2, contractile vacuole, excretory in function. So in this, what is the incorrect matching? Elaioplast oils, chromoplast, colored plastid. So here probably the B option, chromoplast, which are colored plastids, may store the fat or not. So it is the second mismatch. The second B option is the mismatch option. Next, quasi-fluid nature of membrane is due to A, phospholipid, B, integral protein, C, peripheral protein, D, sugar moiety. So already you know that quasi means semi-fluid nature of membrane is because of, already we have discussed the phospholipids. So this is the answer, is the phospholipids. Next, gas vacuole is present in all the bacteria, consist of gas vacuoles. So your blue green algae is a bacterium, purple photosynthetic bacteria is a bacterium, green photosynthetic bacteria is a bacterium. So your gas vacuoles are present in all the above options. That is, all the above options is right. Next, which of the following feature is not associated with centrosome? Pericentriolar material, two cylindrical structures, two centrioles, lipid bilayer covering. So, from the given options, which of the following feature is not associated with the centrosome? Pericentriolar material, two cylindrical structures, two centrioles, lipid bilayer covering. Because the centrioles, centrosome is not a lipid bilayer covering. So here the lipid bilayer is not controlled with that. What is the site of DNA and centriole duplication respectively? Nucleus. What is the site of DNA and centriole duplication respectively? Nucleus and cytoplasm, cytoplasm and nucleus, nucleus and nucleolus. So here the answer is, generally the duplication takes place, the nucleus duplication takes place, and the cytoplasm along with the centriole take place. So here from the given options, nucleus and the cytoplasm will be duplicated in the divisional process. Cell wall helps in cell-to-cell interaction, protects cell from infection, contains minerals like calcium carbonate in certain algae. All are correct. So when you see the options, helps in cell interaction, that is right. Protects the cell from infections, that is also right. Contains minerals like calcium carbonate in certain algae. So when you are saying that it consists of calcium carbonate, so all the three options, that is D option, is right. Read the following statements carefully and choose the correct options with respect to a eukaryotic cell. All eukaryotic cells are identical in structure. Mitochondria and plastids are semi-autonomous organelles. Ribosomes are associated with plasma membrane. There is an extensive compartmentalization of cytoplasm through the presence of membrane-bound organelles. So from these, which options is right? All eukaryotic are identical in structure. All eukaryotes may have the identical structure or may not have the identical structure. Mitochondria and plastids are so second option is right. Second option is right. Ribosomes are associated with plasma membrane. They are associated with Golgi apparatus. So second option is, third option is wrong. There is an extensive compartmentalization of cytoplasm through the presence of membrane-bound organelles. Fourth is also right. So here B option is right. Golgi bodies are involved in, Golgi bodies, you know that they are involved in the synthesis of proteins. They are also involved in packaging of materials. They are also involved in the modification of proteins. That is the reason the endoplasmic reticulum is in direct contact with the nucleus and also Golgi apparatus. So a recycling of broken plasma membrane during endocytosis, synthesis of glycolipids, modification of proteins, all the above. From the given question, the Golgi apparatus performs all the functions. So Golgi bodies are involved in all the above functions. So answer all the above is right. Fourth option is right. Which of the following organelles lack membrane in eukaryotic cell? Cilia, lysosome, rough endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, flagella and centrioles. As per our knowledge, we know that the organelles which lack the membrane in eukaryotic cell are ribosomes and centrioles. So here ribosomes and centrioles, they are D and F. So A option is right option, means they don't have the membranes. Answer is A. Alleroplast, amyloplast and ileoplast divide by multiple fission, store protein, starch and fat respectively, help in photolysis of water, store reserve food and pigments. So coming on to this, alleroplast proteins, allero, already we have discussed that allero protein, amylo starch, ileo oil or fat. So they will be respectively storing the proteins, starch and fats respectively. Reformation of nucleolus, Golgi complex and endoplasmic reticulum occurs in A. telophase, B. metaphase, prophase, C. prophase, D. anaphase. Reformation of nucleolus, Golgi complex and endoplasmic reticulum occurs in the generally the late anaphase and during early telophase. So we can consider that as a late anaphase. Here D option. D option. Ribosomes of the cytoplasm, chloroplast and mitochondria respectively. Ribosomes will be having the of the cytoplasm will be having the 80S type of ribosomes. Chloroplast, as it is a prokaryotic cell in the eukaryote, so it will be having the 70S type of ribosomes, and mitochondria are also having the 70S type of ribosomes. So here B option is the right option. B option is the right option. 70S. Integral membrane proteins are partially embedded in lipid layers or completely embedded in lipid layers, show lateral but not vertical movements within the lipid layer, all of these. So when you look onto the integral proteins are generally partially embedded and some are completely embedded, and also they show the lateral movement but not vertical movement to maintain the stability. So all of these options are the right options. we have discussed already the first part of cell unit of life, and we have discussed certain points in the synapses. Now we are going to discuss about the cell division cycle and cell division. In this already we have discussed some points in the synapses. Now we are going to discuss the question wise synapses, however it is possible, how much it is possible. Now in cell cycle, DNA replication takes place in G1 phase, G2 phase, mitotic phase, S phase. Already we know that in the cell cycle definition itself, we have two things. One is interphase, one is my divisional phase. In the interphase, we have G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase. G1 and S phase are called as active phases of interphase, resting phases, where S synthesis phase is meant for DNA duplication, DNA replication for the first next synthesis. So in cell cycle, DNA replication takes place. Obviously, as per our knowledge, we know that it takes place in the synthesis phase, S phase, option D. During cell division, the spindle fibers attach to the chromosome at a region called, already we know that chromosome is having four chromatids connected at the centromere with the help of a structure called as kinetochore. So here chromocenter, centriole means where the it is on the poles, which is going to mean give rise to the spindle fibers. Chromomere means part of a chromosome. So here, as per our knowledge, we know that the kinetochore, that is where the spindle fibers will attach. So option B is the kinetochore. Kinetochore is the place where the spindle fibers attach to the chromosome before splitting. And chromosomal duplication without nuclear division refers to chromosomal duplication without nuclear division refers to chromosomal duplication occurs and no nuclear division, that is generally so here chromosomal duplication means the doubling of chromosome and no nuclear division means separation of the chromosomes. So it happens in all most of the eukaryotic cells, where the single mother cell is divided into two daughter cells. So it is, the process is generally equational division or mitosis. Option B is the answer. Now, during which stages of prophase 1 substages of meiosis do you expect to find the bivalence and DNA replication respectively? Pachytene and interphase, pachytene and interphase just prior to prophase 1, pachytene and S phase of interphase just prior to prophase 1, zygotene and S phase of interphase prior to prophase 1. So already you know that in the prophase 1, we have 5 phases again. One is leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene, diakinesis. At the zygotene stage, the pairing up of homologous sister chromatids takes place and tetrad formation takes place. And the next part of the question is DNA replication. Already you know that DNA replication takes place in the S phase of interphase. So here, according to the question, when you go on to the option, it starts from zygotene and it divides at diplotene or diakinesis stage. So that is zygotene stage. And DNA duplication takes place in S phase. So from the given 4 options, if you see, we can only go for the 4th option. We can only go for the 4th option, that is D option. Next, coming on to the two chromatids of metaphase chromosome represent, the two chromatids of a metaphase chromosome represent replicated chromosome to be separated at anaphase, homologous chromosomes of a diploid set, non-homologous chromosomes joined at the centromere, maternal and paternal chromosomes joined at the centromere. When you look onto the option, so the two chromatids of metaphase chromosome represent replicated chromosomes to be separated at anaphase, homologous chromosomes of a diploid set, non-homologous chromosomes joined at the centromere, maternal and paternal. Here, the two chromatids of a metaphase chromosome represents it is going to be replicated and separated at anaphase. Replicated chromosome, already it is replicated in the prophase 1, in the synthesis phase, and it is going to be separated in the anaphase. So here we can go with the option A. The option for this answer is A. Next, recombination of genes occur at prophase in mitosis, prophase 1 in meiosis, prophase 2 in meiosis, metaphase 2 in meiosis. Generally, we know that recombination means recombination nodules are formed in the pachytin stage of prophase 1. So we can go with the option prophase 1 in meiosis is the answer for that, where the division of recombination of genes occur, and the option for that is B. Four daughter cells are formed after meiosis are genetically similar, genetically different, anucleate, multinucleate. Four daughter cells formed after meiosis are, they are genetically, generally, may be similar, may not be similar, but obviously based on the meiosite content in them, as you know that they consist of autosomes and allosomes, so they are obviously genetically different. That is, if you take male gamete, that is genetically dissimilar. Genetically means one androgamete is present, that is one X chromosome is present, allosome, Y chromosome is present, allosome. This decides the sex of the baby, whether the baby is male or female. Male or female. So they are genetically, the sperm cell is formed from the similar spermatogonial cell, but they will be having different characters. So they are generally genetically different. B option. In animal cells, cytokinesis involves the separation of sister chromatids, the contraction of contractile ring of microfilament, depolymerization of kinetochore microtubules, a protein kinase that phosphorylates other enzymes. So in animal cells, cytokinesis involves, so generally in animals, the cytokinesis takes place from the end to the middle, the division of cells. And in plant cell, because of the cell wall, it takes from the middle to the periphery. So here, the separation of, in animals, cytokinesis involves the separation of sister chromatids, the contraction of contractile ring of the microfilament, depolymerization of kinetochore microtubules, a protein kinase. B and C options are wrong, and in the separation of sister chromatids have already happened, so we can go with the B option, that is the contraction of the contractile ring of the microfilament and leads to the division of the mother cell into two daughter cells takes place, which is called cytokinesis. So it takes place from the periphery to the middle. Option B. Option B. Next, the number of chromatids in a chromosome at anaphase is. Anaphase means it has the cross the metaphase. So obviously this, the number of chromatids in a chromosome at anaphase will be generally, if you compare that with the mitosis and meiosis of anaphase of mitosis and anaphase of meiosis, generally we can see that in the case of chromatids, generally in the case of mitosis, mitosis will be two, because four, one chromosome is paired, means they will be having four chromatids or tetrad in condition. So from that two will be going up, two will be coming down. So here that will be two in mitosis, and generally probably because of the tetrad formation, bivalent formation, that is pairing up of two bivalent homologous sister chromatids, generally four in the case of meiosis. So here two in mitosis and four in meiosis. During cell division, sometimes there will be a failure of separation of sister chromatids. The event is called as interference, complementation, non-disjunction, coincidence, in which, so here from the question, during cell division, sometimes there will be a failure of separation of sister chromatids. This event is called, so here no separation, failure of separation means non-disjunction. So here interference means one is interfering the other to split. Complementation means combining. Coincidence means it is by chance. But failure means it is non-disjunction. So non-disjunction is the appropriate term we can use for the cell division, separation of sister chromatids. So option C. Now, in which stage of cell cycle histone protein synthesized in a eukaryotic cell? During G2 stage of prophase, during S phase, during entire prophase, during telophase. So in which phase of the cell cycle histone proteins are synthesized in the, already you know that any synthesis means it takes place in the S phase. So here it takes place of probably in the S phase, in the S phase only. So the option B is the right answer, during S phase, during S phase, that is B option. Now what is true about the telophase stage? Chromosomes lose their identity as discrete elements. Chromosome cluster at opposite spindle poles. Nuclear envelope, nucleolus, Golgi complex and embryo, endoplasmic reticulum reform, all of these. So in the telophase, disintegration of or losing the identity of the chromosomes takes place, and they will be opposite poles. When the nuclear membrane envelope is reforming, at the same time the nucleolus, the disintegrated chromosomes, forms the nucleus, and all the functional organs responsible for functionality of this cell, they will be reformed. So here the probable answer will be all or will be the correct options. So D option is the right answer, that is all the ABC options will happen in the case of the telophase. So in continuation to the topic, We try to discuss the next few questions from now onwards. Match column 1 with the column 2 and the select the correct option from the codes given below. So from these options, if you see A, B, C, D option with the column 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 options, and if you match them, disintegration of nuclear membrane takes place in the prophase, you know that. Appearance of nucleolus takes place in the case of the The option is syndromere split and chromatid separate, option A. Now come, maximum cytoplasmic growth occurs in, cytoplasmic growth occurs in the, generally it happens in the G1 and B phase, but after replication only the maximum cytoplasmic growth also takes place. So it 18th one, it takes place in the after the S phase. Generally that takes place before prophase and after synthesis phase. Probably it takes place in the G2 phase, C option. Next, diagrammatic representation of chromosomes of a species is called karyotyping, means chromosomal pattern is called karyotyping. Cryptogram means which cladogram is concerned to the other things, and ideogram, the diagrammatic representation of the chromosomes of a species is considered as a ideogram. So D option, ideogram, is the answer for this. Which one of the following events is incorrect for cell cycle? All events are under genetical control. Maximum cell growth occurs in M phase. DNA synthesis occurs only during one specific phase. One specific centriole duplication takes place in S phase. So coming on to this question, incorrect of cell cycle, all events are under genetical control, but all events are not under genetical control. It happens under the different, like growth. So based on that, all cell cycle, some are under genetical control, some are not under the genetical control. So A option. Next, the sequence of events by which the cell duplicates its genome, synthesis or constituents of cell, and eventually divide into two daughter cells is termed as karyocrosis, I phase, cell cycle, M cycle. The definition itself, you know that the definition is the answer for cell cycle, option C. Lambrecht chromosomes are seen in which typical stage? Coming to the Lambrecht chromosomes, we have come across this Lambrecht chromosomes in the case of the ootid of certain, these are also ootid of the Ichthyosaurus, and these Lambrecht chromosomes are in the diploid chromosomes, which are bivalent and they are not divided. So these Lambrecht chromosomes will be generally seen in the meiotic prophase in the ootid cells, which was first identified in the ootid cells. So Lambrecht chromosomes are in, these are seen in the meiotic prophase. They are only seen in the meiotic prophase of certain cells which are undergoing the division. Next, in telophase of mitosis, the mitotic spindle breakdowns and nuclear membranes form. This is essentially the opposite of what happens in the, so in telophase of mitosis, the mitotic spindle breakdown means it should, the mitotic spindle should form. This happens in which phase? Obviously, probably that will take place in the prophase. That takes place in the prophase. So here, destruction or disintegration, then regeneration. So it happens in the prophase. A option. Most of the cells divide if they receive the proper signal at a checkpoint in the dash phase of the cell cycle. Obviously, if the cell cell get the signal for next division, they will enter the G1 phase. If the cell does not get the signal, they go on to the quotient phase or G0 phase. So that happens only in the case of the checkpoint in that cell division is G1, option B. Next, which of the following carry the same genetical metric information? So generally, when you look onto the chromosomal, if you understand the chromosomal structure, the chromosomes will be having tetrods, that is four chromatids. So in that the which are pairing up are called as sister chromatids. So generally from X and Y, if you take, they have that different genetical information. All autosomes, 5th and 7th mapping of chromosomes is different. 7, 11 is different. 18, 21 is different. So all autosomes will not have the same genetical information. And homologous chromosomes may have the same information, may not. But all the sister chromatids will have the same information. Hence the option A. Next, a zoologist examined an intestine cell from a crayfish and counted 200 chromosomes, each consisting of two chromatids at prophase one of mitosis. What would he expect to see in the each of the four cells of telophase second of meiosis if he looked in the crayfish ovary? So here, in the intestine means it is a somatic cell. Here he has seen 200 chromosomes. So here 200 chromosomes means in the daughter cell also, if it is a somatic cell, we see the same number of chromosomes, that is 200 chromosomes. And counted each chromosome consisting of, so prophase 1. And after division of prophase, means after metaphase, in the anaphase, you see only 100 chromosomes. So here, first option will be 100 chromosomes. And in the telophase, second of meiosis means reductional division takes place. That is meiosis 1 completed, followed by meiosis 2 and telophase. So here, the number of chromosomes are reduced to half from the original number of chromosomes. So it will be probably at the end of the telophase, you can see that one chromatid only. So here the option will be the D option, because somatic cells after the nuclear division, there are 100 chromosomes, and here two chromatids in the four cells will have each chromatid four chromatids. So here option D will be the most appropriate and suitable option, that is D option. And which of the following is true of kinetochores? They are localized at centromere of each chromosome. They are the sites where microtubules attach to the separate chromosome. They are organized so that there is one per sister chromatid in meiosis, all of the above. From this you see that, so you, when you see onto the chromosome at following kinetochores, we are seeing the four, all the three characters are present in the kinetochores. So here option D, that is 27D option, all the three options are present in the kinetochores. So four option, D option is the right option. So the rest of the questions try to do by yourself, and we will see that.